Hey everyone, I'm Ian Atkinson with NASA Spaceflight. Welcome to this week's Starship update video. First off, thanks to Mary at Boca Chica Gal on Twitter. She's a Boca Chica resident and NSF team member who documents activities at the site every single day. All of the following photos and videos are from her unless otherwise noted. Thanks, Mary. Throughout this past week, cleanup of SN8's debris continued at a quick pace. Following its mostly successful flight and crash landing, countless pieces of debris were thrown around the site. Now, only the largest segments remain at the landing pad. This includes the methane header tank, which was the culprit of SN8's failed landing, and the nose cone, which Elon Musk stated may be incorporated into a sort of monument. Meanwhile, the twin suborbital launch mounts have continued to see work this week. Pad A, where SN8 lifted off from, seemed to only take minor damage from the launch. Crews were seen inspecting and repairing the stand ahead of welcoming another Starship to the site. Just next door, work on Pad B has continued. Workers were seen removing concrete forms from around the bases of the six supports. As of recording, Pad B has only hosted one test article, SN7.1, during a cryogenic loading test in September of this year. We currently understand that Pad B will host the next Starship for its test campaign, whether that'll be SN9 or not. Finally, work has resumed on the orbital launch site following SN8's flight. Large amounts of dirt work is in progress around the site, mainly related to installing electrical conduits. On Thursday, crews removed the concrete forms from what is expected to be a bunker or blast wall for the pad. The site also received several deliveries this week, including precast concrete structures and a mobile office building. A new large crane was assembled nearby early in the week, possibly to help in lifting the heavier components of the future launch site. Back at the build site, efforts on rescuing the leaning tower of SN9 have been a success. Last week, we saw that a transport stand supporting Starship SN9 in the high bay collapsed, tilting SN9 into the nearby wall. Luckily, no one seemed to have been injured, and the high bay sustained no visible damage. However, SN9 did receive damage on its two right fins. To bring SN9 back upright, the same crane used to stack SN8's nose cone was brought to the production site and pulled the Starship away from the walls of the high bay. SN9 was then moved onto a new stand, and its two damaged fins were removed. We don't know the exact timeline for SN9's test campaign. However, road closures are scheduled for December 28th through 30th. This may be for a rollout to the pad or even for cryogenic testing. We'll just have to wait and see. At the windbreak, SN10's nose cone received one of its two flaps on Wednesday. The other may have been set aside to replace the damaged front flap on SN9. The nose cone was then stacked onto its four-ring barrel section on Saturday. This four-ring design differs from those of SN8 and SN9, who both used five-ring sections. This is probably a move to help streamline production, since it's likely easier to assemble four rings together than five. Parts for future Starships were also spotted around the facility. A nose cone segment for SN14 was seen on Tuesday, and SN15's aft dome skirt was spotted on Friday. On Thursday, we got a peek into how far ahead they truly are when Mary saw the aft dome section for SN17 being worked on. It's very likely that at least one of these sections will be part of the first Starship to make it into orbit, so personally I'm very excited to see these parts being made. Finally, more parts for the first Super Heavy booster, named BN1 for Booster Number 1, were seen around the facility. Several weeks ago, we saw that the first sections of BN1 were stacked in the high bay, but work seemed to have been paused just after that. However, BN1's common tank dome, which separates the methane and liquid oxygen tanks, was seen on Thursday, just before it was sheathed in a ring segment. Also, a single ring labeled bottom barrel was seen being moved on Friday. And that's all for this week. Thanks for watching, and as always, we welcome any feedback about the video in the comments below. If you'd like to support the channel, consider becoming a channel member. Membership comes with perks like access to the members-only Discord and preview video clips early in the day. Also, you can visit our store with a whole range of t-shirts, posters, and more. We'll see you next week, and have a safe and happy holiday.